sit down in a very comfortable position because this video is going to be extremely very long. So if you guys see my legs, yes, I am wearing leggings. What is this? You know, the night attire, night dress that you guys wear. Yeah, the silhouette, I know. I only look presentable up here and down here I look very... It's okay, we should not talk about it. Hey guys, it's Divya Saravanan. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button and of course join the family. So as for today's video, I've decided to do a girl talk for all my girl babies out there. But I'm not saying this video is just for the girls. I know there are boy subscribers in my channel and you guys might watch it because you want to know about your girlfriend, your mom, your sister. So this is a safe space. I'm not telling the boys to click out of my video. And also, if you feel like you already get to know everything that you're supposed to know, then you can just leave, okay? This video is made specially for the girl subscribers, my babies, my cuties. This is simply because I, as a girl, I find it hard sometimes to even ask my friends, ask my elder sister, ask my mom certain stuff, because when you want to ask, you feel like, is it right to ask them? I know there are certain questions you cannot ask your mom, you cannot ask your sister, but as a big sister, I'm here for you all. I uploaded this on my Insta story asking you all to ask me questions that you guys would like to know for this girl talk video, and boy, I received quite a number of questions. So this video is specially for the girls. Just sit back, relax. I'll try to answer as many questions as I can. So without any further ado, hit the like button, subscribe, and let's get into today's video. Actually created an album in my handphone with all the questions that you guys actually asked me. I will go through every single question one by one. It's gonna be a very long video. First question is not even question, it's actually an advice from my elder sister. Her name is Koshini. She said, just want to remind you, no plantas for now, da chalo. I understand why she said planta, because I heard like quite a number of stories where boys, certain boys, I'm not saying all boys, certain boys, they tend to planta girls, and there are girls out there also who planta boys. I'm not saying anything because I've never been in a relationship before, but then I tend to take advices from elderlies, especially Koshini. Koshini has been telling me a lot of things, so I am listening to this particular advice of her. I am not gonna see, I don't think I'll be looking at any boys for the time being, because I am very engaged in YouTube, I'm very engaged in my education. I want to focus, you know, because when you are in a relationship, you have to give your all. And I don't think I can do it now, because if I want to be in a relationship, I must make sure that I'm putting in effort, and it's not only one-sided, only the boy is giving effort and I'm doing nothing at that. So if you guys are asking me if I'm looking at anyone right now, no, I'm not looking at anyone right now. And do I have a crush on someone? Yeah, I do have crushes, but crushes doesn't mean it might work out, you know? And my crush don't even know I exist. So you guys can already imagine what my love life is gonna be like.
I love you by girl, that's why. I love you by girl, that's why.
From Gayatri, have you ever experienced any relationship problem? How did you overcome heartbreak? Okay, I've never faced any relationship problem because, like I said, I've never been in any relationship before. I've liked boys, I've had crushes before, I've talked to them before, but just things didn't work out. I've had friends who actually went through heartbreaks, especially a few of my friends. They left high school and then they went to uni and then they had boyfriends there. And things didn't work out in between them and then they broke up. So every single time when they call me and they ask for advice, I tend to give the best advice, A-class advice. So if you guys are having problem like with your boyfriend and you recently break up with your boyfriend or something, in order for you to overcome that particular problem, it's gonna be hard. People can easily say, just forget about it, it's gonna take a month or two for you to move on from that problem and then it's done. But trust me, it's not gonna be like that. It's like every single time you do something that reminds you of that person, it's gonna hurt very badly. But I would say, just take it slowly, take it like one at a time. It's gonna be hard because especially when you guys are together for like a very long period of time and suddenly like he did something or you don't like him and then you guys break up, went different part ways, you actually loved him, you know. So like, you know, that love will still be there for that particular person. And I'm trying to give pep talk here. Yeah, thank you. So the love will still be there. I would suggest you guys to like try out something new. Maybe like take up piano classes or maybe go for an art class, especially during this MCO period, I know that there are lessons online, yoga lessons online. So you guys can try to take up these lessons and keep yourself occupied. Make sure to not let yourself to think about that thing over and over again. Don't let your mind empty. If like you are in uni and heartbreaks usually happen in uni, so what you can do is start doing your tutorials, start doing your assignments, keep yourself very occupied. I'm not going to say it's going to make you stop thinking from that particular person 100%, but it will help. Like from 100%, it might reduce to 90, and that's a progress. So I guess that's all I can say for this particular question. Next question. Okay, next question is from Saranya. I got a real question. You used to put love failure kind of things, but also say that you never had a boyfriend. She's angry with an exclamation mark. And the next continuation question that she sent was, so what does that mean with a laughing emoji? I know I've received quite a number of questions like this also. You guys tend to ask me, I've never been through heartbreaks. I've never had a boyfriend. I've never had exes. Then what actually makes me to upload this kind of sad, dying quotes? I am a human, I'm not a robot. Like, things happen to me, but it doesn't mean it has to happen because of a boy, you know. Things happen to me because of uni, things happen to me because of my mood swings, especially during this MCO period, like when I came into Singapore, things has gotten a bit out of hand, where my mood swings tend to get very bad. So like whenever I am sad, you guys tend to see like weird kind of stories on my story. I tend to upload dying quotes, I tend to upload dying songs as if I broke up with someone, but that's not true. If I have a boyfriend, I'll definitely reveal my boyfriend on YouTube just for you guys. And I don't have an ex, I don't have a past. I do have crushes which did not work out. You know, that's the mood that had happened. I hope this clarifies. The next question is actually from Saumya Sharia. Nice name. Broken relationship with my favorite person with an exclamation mark. I would say that's not a question, that's more like a statement. Favorite person, if you have replied to my story, I'm assuming that it's a boy. I would say I'm very sorry because like things don't always work out the way it's supposed to work out. If everything happens the way it's supposed to go, this wouldn't even be life at all, you know. Life has ups and downs. So, like I said in the beginning of my video, there are certain ways for you to overcome this kind of relationship. If you want your relationship to work out, you don't give your all. Don't give like all 24/7, only you keep on putting effort inside. You need that opposite party also to put in effort, you know. So, if things didn't work out, I'm truly very sorry for you guys. But then, I know you got this. Just be a better version of yourself. If that happens because of like the boy cheated on you or something, or maybe your parents found out and you guys cannot go any further, just be a better version of yourself, you know. Because if you're young and if you're just like at the age of 20, 19, 18, this kind of age, it's for you to shine. It's for you to actually prepare yourself mentally in order for you to see the outer world. If like you're off the age of like 24, 25, I'm really not sure because I don't know what is it like 24, 25 years old. I'm speaking from like a 20-year-old perspective. So I hope everything is going on really very fine for you. I'm praying the very best for you. Just stay positive. Okay, the next question is from DXXHA Darsha. Diksha, I'm not sure. You have a boyfriend before? No, the other boyfriend, no past. I mean, I would really love to have a boyfriend, but I'm just thinking about the consequences I have to face. Like, you see, the question you guys ask me, many of y'all ask me how to overcome breakup. So I can actually advise how to overcome breakup, but to apply whatever I see in my life, it's going to be very hard for me. So I don't want to go through that phase, you know. I'm already very stressful with university, and if a guy ever come and propose to me, I would just ask him to move on, you know, find a girl. A better girl is waiting for you out there. I'm just not the one because I'm not ready. Even if I'm ready, I don't even know if I'll be. You know, I don't think I'll ever be in a relationship now. If you guys ever see me being in a relationship now, just come back to this video and comment. Akka, you said you won't be in a relationship. What are you doing? Comment down, okay? Next question. Okay, next question is from Kachu_99. What to give my boyfriend for his birthday this year? Please give me a list. I love you. Thanks in advance. Ah, she said thank you already. I need to do my job. What? I would say if I have a boyfriend and if I were to give him like a birthday gift on his birthday, I am the type that I really value handmade stuff. I don't like if people randomly go to like, you know, online shop and just like buy a freaking frame of like our pictures and then, oh, happy birthday, what did you do? I don't need to thank you, you know. I need to go and thank the person who did the photo frame for me. Okay, this question question is from Kushini again. Why do boys cheat and play with girls' feelings? Question I answer means the boy who's still watching the video, give me serupadi one. I am not saying that only boys cheat. There are girls out there who cheat also. They are the type, probably they don't know what is love yet, I think. Because they are not in a relationship because they want you. They are in a relationship because they want entertainment. They want to be loved. Some people, they get into a relationship simply because they want to spend time with someone. And at the same time, you know, you don't get into a relationship just because you want to get into a relationship. You know, things have to happen on its own. So I guess that is why, once you like get into a relationship when you don't want, you tend to cheat and like play double game. There are friends of mine who have like this kind of problem where their boys actually cheat on them and like they have like two girls, three girls behind. So I would say when you are trying to get into a relationship, make sure you know that boy thoroughly. Do not, your heart is very fragile, you know. Your parents make your heart very strong. Don't carry your heart and give it to a boy, then the boy randomly come and cho-cho, do something, and then your heart break. You know, you've been through a heartbreak because the boy cheated on you or the girl cheated on you. I would say, don't give a second chance. If that person actually turned into a new leaf, you stay back and see if that person actually turned into a new leaf. You don't want to give that same person your heart again, and then the person kill you again. You understand? So you have to make sure that particular person, if they cheated on you and you're trying to give him a second chance, make sure you're ready and make sure that particular person is ready to do anything for you at all.
All is well, all is well. Solara.
Solta, ella prachane seriyaiduma?
Illa anda prachane samalikkira oru dhairyam onnu varum.
I hope you all had a great time watching this girl talk. I had a very great time answering to all of these questions. It's basically me advising myself to not be harsh on myself. So thank you to you guys for actually asking this question, because I feel like it's a responsibility for me to be an akka for everyone out there, to tell you guys stuff that you're supposed to do and not supposed to do. If you guys would like to reach out to me for any other question, or if you guys would like to see a part 2 of this video, make sure to comment down below and I will try my level best to do a part 2 of this video. Okay? Stay safe and you can make a difference. Bye guys!